an intruder. These people are under my protection. I'll not let you harm them. Hearken to my words, wicked creature. Return to the pit of evil from whence you came.
Don't listen. Who knows what spells it weaves around us? Quickly, cleric.
Helm, protector of all, grant me the power to ignite this creature's flesh and burn its bones to ash. Begone, monster. Your hag mother holds no power here. Spawn would speak like that. Forgive the paranoia. We're being hunted by a vile and wicked hag. We feared you, her minion. She's already hexed one of us, and any of us could be next. Because we dared to do the impossible. We dared to fight back. You see, all of us here have fallen victim to a hag's vicious ways. But instead of succumbing to despair, we rose above it, thanks to Mayrina, our leader. Together, we've been helping others who've suffered at the claws of a hag. Only, Mayrina's been hexed by the very hag who now hunts us. You're the one that saved her. The one that ventured to the depths of Ethel's lair. I can hardly believe it. You look so normal. By Helm, perhaps there is hope. If anyone can help Mayrina, it's you. She's upstairs. But be warned, she's not as you remember her.
Innocence against the hag.
Ready and willing. Oh, yes. What an ugly doll. I'd only give this to a child I didn't like.
You removed my hex. That's annoying. I wanted to play a little longer. Auntie likes her toys broken. She's not going to be happy I had to get my hands dirty. They want to hurt Auntie. They have the book. I will die before I let anyone touch a hair on her head. The others I will leave to rot in this house. But you, I will gift Auntie your corpse wrapped in your own intestines.
Not the Red Cuts! Oh, please! Not again!
Find somewhere to camp soon.
Honor, my love. I'm sorry, Connor. I'm so sorry.
That lying, thieving, scaly little shit. Thanks for knifing the bastard. That makes twice you've saved me. I'm starting to think you're my guardian angel. Thanks, but my mouth tastes like mutton, and I'm itching in hard to reach places. I'm gonna make the witch that did this pay, and I have the means to do it. This group is made of survivors, people like me who've been hurt by hags. I brought them together to fight back. We tracked a hag to the city, but lost her trail right after she snatched a little girl. None. Her mother has no idea of what she's up against. Poor woman thinks the fist will be able to help her. The moment I started investigating the missing girl, I felt the hag's eye on me. Next thing, I was sprouting wool and bleating up a storm. Thank you. With you at our side, that hag won't know what hit her. Check the safe in the back. I've done my homework on hags since we last tangled with Ethel. Take whatever you need.
I know it by heart anyway.
Laura was knocking about Basilisk Gate at the Flaming Fist's headquarters. Good luck.
Good. I might get some sleep if I took
the... Don't touch me.
Careful, Connor. Stay close. There's a right time for a strike. Now, not when the whole city's in danger.
There'll always be an excuse. Anything to kick.
Good, I guess.
What are we here?
Talking the way you're talking, the fists will start breaking heads.
Good. I might get some sleep if I took a crack on the noggin.
I don't have any of those. Sorry.
How are you feeling, Connor? I missed the signs. Same as usual. That's good, I guess. Promise. So just hang on.
What to do?
This is all my fault. Meirina was hexed mere days after the Dragonborn joined us. Why didn't I see it? That's no excuse. I know what they're like. Yet still, I welcomed the Dragonborn with open arms. Meirina was right about you. Thank you for saving her when I couldn't. In the Hag's gaze, vigilant one. I beg of you.
Anything to keep us in our place.
The Dragonborn was Kled's friend. Why? Why would he hurt Lady Meirina? But Lady Meirina was kind to him. To us. Anyone who hurts Lady Meirina is Kled's enemy. But anyone who helps her is Kled's friend. Thank you.
Good, I guess.
Flooding in here, driving down our wages even more.
Well, no. Wouldn't want that. Lord Gortash needs to send the Steel Watch through here. Mop up all this riffraff.
God, I think even they'd have their work cut out for them.
And what if it doesn't work?
We keep going until it does work. They'll give in soon enough once their coffers run empty.
It's much safer if it happens when my belly runs empty.
Should have at least locked the place up properly
ahead.
Not the city's in danger.
That would be the mind restoring charge.
Trust me.
I don't have any of those.
I appreciate it,
right? What are you after, friend? Got grub, potions, a few nice vintages? Best stock up now before someone clears me out to fill their larder.
Anything else?
Watchful eyes upon you.
Stupid of him if I Trust me, it's much safer this side of the city walls.
Should have at least locked the place up proper before they left.
Easy.
Sense watchful eye.
Where they're walking.
You've been caught in the act. So much for the perfect crime. Your refusal has made...
Shadowheart needs to speak to her more than I do. Better wait until...
Being arrested for theft. If you have a defense, make it now. They believe you, for now. But something tells you they won't be so receptive to your charms again. Your stealing has caught someone's attention. What will you do? Walk free for now, but your stories won't land so well if you're caught again.
Here's a tip. Latest Baldur's Mouth edition. Oh, dynamite! That Lord Gordon.
Quick stamp. How about this?
Nothing.
Someone's reported a theft in this area. It seems you're the likely culprit. What will you do? Your silken words deflect any suspicion. Your presence here is beyond reproach.
Easy enough.
Yes.
All right.
Not when the whole city is.
Keep a blade close.
Let's be quick.
What have we here?
I don't need a reflection to know this looks fabulous.
When it comes to magical protection, I'm really spared out.
That patter works on bunters. But I know, you spend your wages on sweets.
Incredible.
Trust me, when you're older...
Just one gold piece. That's all I ask.
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Some victuals then? Or a small glass of wine?
I already said no. Now move along, you're scaring away my customers.
Chances. It's you. Ah, and the heart-stopping bloodsucker. I hope you've changed your mind. My neck is yours anytime.
And I will keep refusing until the end of time. I'm done bowing to the whims of others.
Never say never. Forgive the mess. Your blood is far more volatile than I'd anticipated. It's a breakthrough in the sanguine arts, the likes of which the world has never seen. The Grand Matriarch will have no choice but to restore House Ablodra after I present her with my research. But listen to me, rabbiting on about myself when I have you, the prize bleeder, on my very doorstep. If you'd come inside, we could discuss something far more exciting than drow politics. Yes, that is, do follow me.
New uniform, coin in your pocket, and the pick of the finest strange the city's got to offer.
That might be worth a look.
Lisi Ash can be... Ah, a cozy little spot, isn't it? These four walls have witnessed greater alchemical triumphs than the keep of Urngarth Durand. And now that you're here, the crown jewel of my research is soon to be faceted. All you have to do is drink Formula Gruner.
If that's a formula I can smell, it's even fouler than her blood. Oof. Gods below.
When you first entered this home, you saw the incredible latent power within your blood exposed in all its nuances. Formula Gruner will unleash that power within you. Risky, but, safe.
A potion that makes you explode. Seems a bit drastic.
Oh, marvelous. I've never been so excited for anything in all my days. Just stand over there, far over there, and drink up.
Half the new recruits will be in the same way. There's no rush. Keep sucking in that sea air. Good for what ails you.
Ail? Don't even say it.
What's next, I wonder? On I go.
Excuse me, where do you think you're going? Yes. You'll meet
me. Please.
Excuse me, where do you think you're going?
You'll need to take the potion here, please.
Come on. Explosive!
Got a few souvenirs from the night stuck to your chin.
Oh my! My heavens, you lived! This is incredible! I'm seeing stars! I'd hypothesized you wouldn't, my friend, and you've proven me absolutely correct. You are the world's first detonative exsanguinator. To put it simply, from this day on, your blood goes boom. Big boom. It's incredible. All it needs is a spark. I assure you, the pleasure is entirely, entirely mine. This research will skyrocket House of Blodra back to the forefront of Drow scientific thought. Indeed, it could protect my line for generations. Now, let me offer you a little treat. In exchange for the teensiest vial of your marvelous blood, I'll give you something that'll really throw your enemies for a loop. I'll only ask a nominal fee in exchange. You really are a fine collaborator. Until next time.
Ale. Don't even say it.
Imagine the look on Mulds' face.
Keep your distance, darling.
No. Hold on a
second. Certainly.
Soon you'll have a handsome new uniform.
A little souvenir.
Like I forced it down his neck.
Vacant as an orc skull.
Careful not to trigger that thing.
Oh dear. Someone's left a trap out for us. Pleasure. Interesting.
Don't bother, it's broken.
A little more work on my nose, and House of Blodger will be restored.
Half the new recruits will be in the same way. There's no rush. Keep sucking in that sea air. Good for what ails you.
Ale. Don't even say it.
Bloody hells.
Need to see if the new addition's out yet.
This is the private abode of Alexander Rainforest. Friends make appointments, clients respect office hours.
For the side of the city wall.
Hello? Ooh, are you the new cheese dropper? I do hope so. I'm almost down to the last crumbs. Alexander was his name. He dropped all manner of morsels, but the cheeses were the best until the red man visited. A dwarf, all dressed in red. He smiled and held Alexander close, and then Alexander was shouting and struggling, and soon he was all dressed in red as well. So many red morsels fell out of Alexander. They tasted like salt and rust. Very good, even better than cheese. A way to make more people red and to spill their tasty morsels. Go away now. Your delicious scent makes me crave your morsels, but it would be rude to bite you.
Should have at least locked the place up proper before they left.
Fourth for me. City's going to shit.
the lot of
How about
and
this?
Not a thought for their neighbors.
Subtle steps.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
Regards you lifelessly.
He was short, dressed in red.
The corpse remains silent. It does not know. The corpse remains silent. It does not know.
Investigating odd records. Tombstone. Decades now.
The spell's power wanes. You can ask no more questions.
Careful, I might. Let's see.
Thinking they might have their work cut out for them.
Hardly a challenge. A trap. Someone doesn't like visitors.
Dribble's foot. Oh, and it smells even worse than it looks. Oh. Vacant as an orc skull.
Vacant as an orc skull. Step at a time.
No one will.
Keep your distance, darling. What's in here? Watch your back. This way.
Want a drink?
No, you moron! We could be fired for this.
today.
Like a wraith. Let's go. Watch your back. Certainly.
Eventually, citizen.
My friend dared me to come here alone for a couple of mugs of ale. So here I am. Come off it, mate. Who would want me dead?
You're going
going on a date? Are you joking?
The city is a hair's breadth from violence, and we're shipping off at first light.
So? I'll be back by then.
Mate, you'd be late to your own funeral. Look, skip the date, and I'll take you out the next time we port, all right?
Her eyes shine with concern and love, that of more than a friend.
Love? Well, I wouldn't go that far, but yeah, I'm worried about you, mate.
Ship wouldn't be the same without you.
Oh, come on. You know I'm a sucker for that soppy shit. Fine, no date. But let's say we grab another one here for the road. My treat.
Deal.
No pissing or shitting. If you break it, you pay for it. Any fighting and Captain Grizzly will shank you. Got it? Then piss in your cup, like the rest of us. Good. Welcome to the Blushing Mermaid.
Reminiscent of Ethel's swamp hole for my liking.
The baby must be so happy with Auntie. Just help myself.
baby? Do you hear the baby crying? Oh, never mind. Auntie got it.
The baby must be getting so big. I can't wait to see.
They used to laugh at me, but not anymore. Auntie made them stop, and she let me watch. I love you, Auntie.
Auntie promised me treasure. I'm gonna be rich. So rich.
So big. I can't wait to see. She sees my chores are done. The baby must be getting so big. I can't wait to see. Baby must be so happy with Auntie. I am.
Hope your soul is in good hands.
There's blood in the air.
I'll shank the bastards, Auntie! I swear!
Yeah.
Here. pushing on.
A little souvenir. Oh dear. Someone's left a trap out for us. Don't mind if I do. There are traps about. What have we here? That might be worth a look. This way.
Well, hello. There. Be careful. There are traps. If I must.
How many times do I need to say it? You sent word about a lead, said that I should come see you about it.
Of course, madam. Let me just... Forgive me, why are you here?
Is this some kind of sick joke? Do you have any idea what I've been through these past few days? Yes. Her name is Vanra. This stupid, useless fist said she had a lead, but she must have been stuck in Dream Mist or something.
Madam, tell me. You said she was taken from a tavern?
Yes. The blushing mermaid down by the docks. I told you 100 times. Why aren't you listening?
Excuse me, citizen, but if this is a criminal matter, it's my business, not yours. Now, madam, if you'll just tell me why you're here, I'll take down the details.
What is happening? I feel like I'm going mad!
Her name is Vanra. She's 7 years old and has red hair, like me. We were in the Blushing Mermaid when she was taken. Just up by the docks. No, unless you count a couple of old drinking mates at the next table. But they'd be no help. They barely remember their own names. I was sober, though. I swear. I stop in the maid for a drink sometimes. But it was only a quick one. Of course, the front of house, Bosun Gannet was there, and the owner of the Blushing Mermaid, Captain Grizzly. Neither lifted a finger to help me look. It was awful. Thank you. I'll head home. Can't stand being around these idiots any longer. Come find me the moment you hear anything.
Over there. Interesting.
Ready for you. Step by step.
There is work to do. On I go.
Over here.
Time to rest. Very well. Looking ahead.
No, Petal. That wasn't very polite. Did you think you were the first? That I didn't plan for it, Petal? That said, I'm shocked and appalled, Petal. I can't believe you'd try to gut me out in the open like that. After all, it's not just me anymore. I'm... What is it they say? Eating for two. I gobbled myself up a sweet little girl, and she was so very tasty. Venra sits in my belly, growing fed with power. In time, I'll vomit her up and have myself a fresh young hag to train. I have you beat, so do the heroic thing. Die.
Never. If she dies, she's taking the child with her. This should work.
What did you... Stay down, Venra! Oh! No! Stay down! me a fresh young hag. I'm going to paint the wall with your guts, you little shit stain.
Thank you.
waste.
Better get to it.
It's been a long day. I'll need to rest soon.